What's up, you guys? Welcome back to the channel. Thank you so much for clicking on today's video. So a little disclaimer before we get into it, I just want to say that I'm really, really passionate about this topic that I'm going to be talking about. So if I'm kind of rambling incoherently, it's just because this really is something that kind of strikes me at the core of who I am. So it's just something that I really care a lot about. So I apologize if the points that I make maybe don't make the most sense, but it's something that honestly just at the core of my being is something that I'm really, really passionate about. So jumping straight into it, I'm sure as most of you guys know, I am a, what you wanna call, I guess you could call it a weight loss influencer, right? I'm someone that's lost a lot of weight and now I'm trying to help people do the same thing and trying to teach people the right way to do things. Now, through the years, I've been doing this for what, 4 or 5 years now, I have met people that do things similar to me, right? They've lost some weight, now they're trying to help people lose weight as well. So as somebody who has a large audience or a small audience, whatever you wanna call it, right? Something that's really important to me is my integrity and being honest to the people that are following, right? I always want to help the people that are following me. I never, ever want to hurt somebody or tell them a lie in order maybe to gain something out of that. That is something that I could never do, and I can never sleep at night knowing that I'm lying to the people that are following me. Before we go any further, let's talk about what actually happened. So I was actually scrolling through my Instagram and I ran across somebody that now it's somebody that I used to follow that has lost a good amount of weight and also has an audience, right? And they posted, I still can't believe that this happened, but they posted a picture. Now they deleted it and I wish I would have taken a screenshot of it, but you guys, I guess we just have to kind of trust what I'm saying. I promise I'm not lying, but it was them drinking this shake. It was from like that one of those fit tea companies. They were drinking a shake, and in the caption of that picture, they said, "Drinking this shake will help you lose weight 3 times faster than diet and exercise alone." So when I saw that, I literally like stopped and I read that like 4 times. I was like, there's no way this person is saying that. Because again, like I said, the biggest issue I have is that they are someone that's lost weight, that has a big following on social media because they have lost weight. So obviously the people following them are people that are trying to lose weight. So I couldn't believe that I was reading what I was reading, because I know for a fact that person does not believe what they just wrote. So I commented on the post and basically all I said was, 3 times as effective as diet as exercise, and I put a question mark, right? And then the person DM'd me on Instagram, and this is what I can actually show you. Now, I'm not gonna be putting their screen name up or anything like that. This isn't about trying to throw hate on a person. The reason I'm making this video is to just bring awareness to the people out there that are trying to lose weight, to always question the people that you look up to, myself included. Never just take what they say and just completely believe it, especially if they are promoting a product. Especially if they're promoting a product. That is 100%. If they're promoting a product, I'm not saying everyone's lying when they're promoting stuff, but you have to take everything with a grain of salt. That's why I'm bringing this up. I'm not trying to put hate on this person. Again, I'm not even gonna put their name out there, but that's why this video is getting made. So as you can see in the DM that the person sent me, again, they sent me this without me sending anything to them in their DM. They said, "Sell out to get out of debt, no shame in my mom game." And they said, "I delete posts once my contracts are up." And I said, "Don't you feel bad spreading misinformation? I'm honest if someone shoots me a DM. They're similar to ingredients that you buy at any shake at GNC. And then I said, 3 times more effective than diet and exercise. You don't see a problem in promoting that." And then they reply, "John, I do." So they do know that there's a problem with what they're saying, but they're still saying it. And they said, "I have a 4-year-old to feed, so I'm going to do whatever is legal and in my ability to do so. When you're a parent and in the hole, you'll understand." Now, the first point that I wanna make is, obviously, I don't have any children. I can only imagine how hard it would be to provide for a child, but, and this is a big but, I don't think that that's a valid excuse to deliberately lie to people to make money off of them. I'm not trying to virtue signal, I'm not trying to do any humble bragging with this video, but the fact that this person knows they're lying, and the fact that they know this product doesn't do anything for the people buying it, and they're still willing to completely lie to people. And yes, they said, you know, if they send me a DM, I will be honest, but it's not like everybody's gonna send you a DM. And so what are you gonna say when they DM you? Does this really work? And you're just gonna reply with, "No, it doesn't really work. I'm just trying to make money." Like, I don't personally believe that. Again, I understand how hard it probably is to make money and try to provide for a child, but I genuinely believe, as an influencer, there are so many ways that you can make money that doesn't involve lying to your audience. You can make shirts, you can make meal plans, you can make diet books, you can make so many things that could actually help people that doesn't involve lying to them. I just don't believe that excuse that I'm just doing this because I need to provide for my family. And if that is your excuse, you need to find a better way to do it, because there are better ways to do it. When you make an audience online, you open yourself up to so many opportunities. And circling back again, my biggest issue with this is the fact that this person, their following, are people that are trying to lose weight and desperate to lose weight and will try anything. And there's always the excuses, it shouldn't be their fault, right? It should be the people that are trying to lose weight that fell for it, right? You have to learn from your mistakes. The thing that I have an issue with is that she knows that she's lying. She knows that this isn't going to work, and then promoting it to people that are trying to find something. Now, I agree, if you go buy that shake, like, you should have the knowledge that that stuff doesn't work. But if you're following somebody that you trust, that you look up to, that has lost weight, and you think, okay, if they are promoting this, they obviously think it works. The logic there is, like, you trust that person, so you're gonna do what they say. That's the issue that I have. It's like, you have that following, you have that responsibility, and to just completely lie to them to make a quick buck, how do you sleep at night? Like, how do you live with yourself when you know you're lying to someone like that? I actually had a friend of mine message me, and they kind of played devil's advocate. They're like, I just want to hear what you think. Don't think that I'm trying to at all, like, say you shouldn't have messaged that person or said what you said. But they're like, what if you were offered $200,000 to promote this product? Would you do it? And I thought about it, and the answer was still no. And again, I'm not trying to virtue signal. I'm not trying to humbly brag, because again, $200,000 would completely change my life, right? I'm not sitting here with tons and tons of money, but again, it comes down to my integrity and being able to sleep at night knowing that I'm not lying to people. And if I took that money and then I started lying to people, like, I wouldn't be able to continue posting, I wouldn't be able to continue making these videos, I wouldn't be able to continue doing what I do, knowing that I'm just sitting there lying to people and taking their money and them putting their trust in me and me just throwing that away. That's the reason I don't think no amount of money, and I know people are probably not gonna believe me, even if it was $1 million, I don't think I would be able to do it. Okay, like I said, I'm sorry. I knew I was gonna go off on tangents in this video, but I wanna circle back to the reason I'm making this is, if you are following people online that are weight loss influencers, health and fitness influencers, and they are making a post about a product, again, I'm not saying there's anything wrong with being an influencer and making money from the people that follow you, right? There's tons of ways to do that with integrity. There's tons of ways to do that with, you get something out of the transaction, right? And your followers get something out of the transaction and everyone's happy. But there are definitely ways to do it where it's wrong, where you're getting something out of it and you are completely shoving your followers down and putting them in a deeper hole. And that's what I feel like is happening. So again, if you are following people and they start promoting something, don't just blindly follow. Always question, always ask, always try and figure out, why is this person promoting this? Does this actually work? Because that's your job as a consumer, right? Don't just fall for everything that you see, and that's the reason that I wanted to make this video. So there it is, that's my rant. I think I've said everything that I needed to say. I hope I didn't miss anything, but yeah, that's it. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. There was one other thing that I wanted to say. Oh yeah, look how buff I am.
Obey the warning signs, and when there are flashing lights or wigwags, don't attempt to cross until they come to a complete stop.